How do we do that, folks? I'm going to get right to the point. How do you repair a S30 valve? Now, I've been having problems with this. Every time I inject the CO2 into this thing, it starts spraying out the top, and it's not going into the barrel. See, this little rubber band here is where the CO2 is pushed. When the bulb is put in, the CO2 pushes the band slightly, and the CO2 pours into the barrel. But I've had the problem of so many bulbs. I've got these bulbs, and they cost money. And every time you sort of, okay, it works the first time, and then it starts playing about like that. And these things, it's just, it really does wind me up, because these things are dear. Well, you know, ones that are getting wasted. I want my CO2 to go into the pressure barrel, and it's not happening. Then I come up with this idea, someone done. You get a piece of siphon hose, right? It has to be a certain sort of width or what have you. So, eight mil? It's about an 8 mil, possibly. Yeah, it's an 8. It looks like an 8 mil tube, or it might be a 9. But obviously, it's got to be the same size as your thing there, so it can be pushed in. You get any idea, folks? So, when I done it, plastic holder things for the bulbs are rubbish, because obviously they. I had to cut this one down because I've got new things for my barrel. They're slightly, the screw's on the outside instead of being in the bottom, it's on the outside, so you can tighten it if it starts leaking or what have you. But the holders were too, sort of, the threads were too long, so I had to cut it down. I'm gonna have to cut this one with a hacksaw because I've got a metal one. Much better, you know, you put the bulb inside it and then screw it on. But I'm gonna cut a bit of that off with a hacksaw. So, right, so you got your siphon tube. You need a pair of scissors for this one to cut about. Let's take a look at this. I'd say so about 3 mil. 3 mil. There's the scissors. I should have everything really prepared, pretty much. So. Cut a lovely section off, 3 mil, something like that. Yeah, just a small piece. Lovely. That might be a bit too big, actually. But let's get in close, folks. Come over here. That might be a little bit too big, that one. But basically, the idea is you put it into the inside there, and it creates a cushion for when the bulb has been screwed on. See, I'm trying to get this in here, folks, at the moment. Right, I'll get in there. Get something sharp like this. Just push it in. I'll take it back out. Right, that's not in yet. I'll still maybe get the bulb. Whoops. Just push it in with that, perhaps. Oh yeah, there you go. Nice. There's actually quite a long pin on this one, actually. So depending on the size of the pins, some of them are quite small, so you have to do a lot of screwing to get the bulb to pierce. But this one's quite a high pin, so depending on the size of the pin, because you want the sort of rubber seal to be sort of just slightly above it, like a mil above it, so when you're screwing the bulb on, it's going to push against it, then start creating force on the piece of siphon in there, so it's creating like a wedge and a seal. So as soon as that pierces the bulb,
it will squirt straight into the barrel instead of spraying back out in your face. I've had that so many times, lost so many bowls because of that, and it's so annoying. But there it is in there. Even so, I might have to take that bit of siphon out. That bit of siphon for me might be a bit too short. But there you go, folks. That is the idea of it. Anyway.
Right then. There it is. Oh, actually, put that. Wear a little. Screw this on. So obviously when you screw down on this, it get to the, and then sort of cushion against the bit of siphon tube, and then once you do another sort of turn, so it starts squeezing, it squeezes and it gets that siphon tube, and then all of a sudden it's going to go pop, and it's going to spray the CO2 straight into the barrel and stare straight into your face. So it does work. I've got two now. I've got two, I've sorted it. And it works every time. And also, I had the problem of it sort of sometimes, the CO2 injecting too fast and blowing the washer off of the bottom. So if every time I remove the bulb from the valve, CO2 was coming out because obviously the washer's been dislodged. So with this idea as well of putting the siphon tube inside to cushion it, it doesn't spray all of it in at once. It slowly, little tiny little pierce hole it creates, and it slowly injects the CO2 into the barrel instead of like one big boosh. It slowly does it. Because I was worried, because I've got these ones, because I started making a lot of stout. They're going to be my main beers from now on. And I've got these NO2, so, and these are different things, bulbs, different valve ends, and I thought, oh, and these, obviously for one, it costs quite a bit, so I didn't want to waste them, but with this idea, it works straight away, no problems. So it creates a creamy head, NO2, is it nitrous oxide or something like that? But please, folks, give this a go.